Can you please help me figure out what is the fascination with Kevin Samuels, his logic, what he has to say? Like, how did he just explode onto the scene? Like, what makes him so, like, what makes people gravitate to his message so much?
From a guy's, from like why guys like your,
yeah.
Yeah, me. I want to hear what Brandon said. I just want him, you to be more.
I don't know.
He be saying what dudes want to say, but scared to say. Flat out.
Yeah.
That's why we like him, because most dudes want to pander to women to get that ass.
You know. Matt Saint Quetic, man, the girl was heaven sent. Matt Saint Quetic, man, the girl was heaven sent.
You know what I'm saying? Right. You know, that's what it. Like, a lot of dudes out here are pandering to women to get that ass or to get whatever. And he's just like, bruh, like, you getting a bad end of the deal because a lot of these women trying to finesse you, do this, you know what I'm saying? He's trying to, and I'm not saying everything he says is good, but, like, y'all got, women have always had other women champion y'all, talk about how y'all got it bad, this, you know what I'm saying? And we, now we having a man that said, for real, in the terms of marriage, because a lot of what he's talking about is, like, you know, marrying a woman and how, you know, picking the wrong one could, you know what I'm saying, be devastating to a man, which is real, because like he gives y'all facts, y'all just don't like hearing it.
You did get excited,
man, because that's it, man, because that's it, man, and that's it, because that's me. I watch Kevin saying, because I'm watching you get a laugh, because it's funny, like I told you that last clip, that was funny to me, but that's really what it is, like. I'm not that tight. Like, stuff Kevin Samuels said, I kind of been saying that already. And I say it to a woman's face, like, is what it is. But a lot of men not saying that, not really. They talk it behind it, pillow talk behind to their boys, but when they in the girls' face, they're not saying that. But they just not. Bro. I don't know what it is. Girl just that bad. Don't want to say. He, like Brandon said, he want to hit. So he not going to say that, because, you know, if he say that, he not going to, you know, not going to get none. So they watch it. That's how I see it. That's how I kind of something they watch. Men watch it, like, who be really watching it. They watch it for that.
Like, they just be watching it like, yeah.
I mean, bro. Like, these women, like, it's not funny laughing, cause some women, you know, I applaud them for going on there trying to get advice, and, you know, and the ones who are actually able to listen and take it. You know, so, you know, I applaud them for that. They want to hear a male perspective, and, you know, and saying you was talking like, well, women say the same thing. Yeah, they don't want to hear it from y'all. They don't. Women don't want advice from a woman. It is what it is. They don't.
That is true. That is true.
So
that is true.
And it's like, I like the straight, blunt delivery of Kevin. I feel like I can relate to it. Women have a problem with it. Because he's sugarcoating it, or he's being his delivery. So like I said last time, sometimes he got to tell it to them like that, or it's not, the woman not going to get it, bro. They really not, bro. It's going to go right over their head what he trying to tell them or enlighten them on. So he got to speak, say it to them as a woman will, oh, why he say it to rude like that? I don't know, bro, is it the truth or not, bro? Is he saying, like, look at how, get past of how he's saying it, but is it real, or is he right or wrong what he's saying? And most of the time, he'd be right. Some stuff would be a little too far, but I don't know. That'd be funny. I watch it get a laugh. That'd be funny to me. He'd be cracking me up. I don't even watch it, but if I see it, I'm religious to see it for a laugh, see what he's about to say, or see what the girl's response about to be. That's it. I'm not. Those things be an hour long, but guys be like, say, ooh, oh, bro, you got like car ride playing that thing. I'm like, God damn. I'm like, yeah, leave it.
Man. All right. So I asked that because I do feel like, from what I be hearing sometimes from him, he just be like, y'all women need to choose better. So I'm just going to end it off with this question. Like, so how can women choose better? Like, what do y'all consider, like, a grown man? Like, what should a man, like, have or possess that would make him, like, a good quality or a good catch? You know what I mean? Like, how can women choose better? What should women be looking at? If we're not supposed to look at his 6 feet, his six figures, his this and that, what should we be looking at? Like, what would be considered a good grown man? Like, you know?
All right, let me ask the girl something. Brittany, how tall is your father?
How tall is who?
Your father.
My daddy was about 6'1".
Okay, what about you, Sinquetta, your father, your stepfather?
My dad is probably like a little bit taller than me, so maybe like 5'6", 5'7".
All right, so I asked you that question because I think a lot of girls should go after what their father was, because like that's the first representation of what a man is like, and that's what I think why like fathers are so important, because for their daughters, that's going to be that first representation of a man. You see what I'm saying? So like, was your father making six figures? Maybe he was, maybe he wasn't. Was your father driving a BMW? It was really like your father loved you, and I'm sure he had some type of character. So you should be going after that. But a lot of women, like, if you ask them that question and maybe they don't, their dad wasn't 6'1", or didn't have all this money, or didn't have it, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, like, so why are you so focused on that? You see what I'm saying? So I think, you know what I'm saying, it comes down to, I mean, I said it before, it's a mindset, because like, you know what I'm saying, like I've been fortunate enough to, you know what I'm saying, have a job making good money, lose it, and then bounce back. I mean, it took me like damn near 2 years, but I got back. You see what I'm saying? So like, I mean, it depends, you know what I'm saying, but I think it's a character. What you got to say, Chris?
How can y'all find a grown?
Or how would you describe a grown man? Like, what does that look like, you know? Or what does a good man look like, you know?
I'll tell them, but it's not possible for them because what Brandon said. You got to look how a man's talking to you. Got to look how a man's talking to you. If you pay attention to how he talks to you, how he treats you, you can see it. But they're not going to see that. They're not going to look at that. They're going to look at height, look at money, car, materialistic things, and I don't feel bad for them when they get hurt or get in a bad situation because they thought they was talking to someone who had these things, but it turned out to be a little kid, or as y'all call, a little boy, or whatever. So you have a better judge of character, man. You don't know how to judge. You don't know how to read or someone's character. Why are you trying to talk? Why are you looking for someone there? You know, it's something that's a hard thing to say. That's a hard thing. You can't. There's nothing we can tell women. You need to look for this and this. The best thing to start is watch, pay attention to how he talks to you, how he talks to you. That's a start, and you got to go from there.
Like how he, like, you know what I'm saying? Is he saying things and then he's following up? Like, for example, my ex, she would say things, a lot of things, and it would be no action. You know what I'm saying? And like, I think it's the same thing for men. You know what I'm saying? It's like, okay, like you got to develop a plan and execute it. You know what I'm saying? It might take time. If you got a woman who worried about what car you driving and how people perceiving you, it's like you're not really looking for a relationship. You're looking for an image. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? And that's what's wrong with a lot of women. They confusing love with an image. You know what I'm saying? And that's sad. You know what I'm saying? It's really sad.
Or like an ego boost. You know what exactly. I mean? Like, I want him because he makes me look good. You know what I mean? Like, all my friends going to be like, oh, girl. You know, like.
Yeah, girl started saying this. I started this trend. You said you even agreed a little bit too, saying, you know, money make you look better.
Mm-hmm. So, Brandon, I was going to ask you, what if the woman didn't have a relationship with her dad? What if her dad wasn't there? So then who is she supposed to model a good man by?
So I had an ex, right? And this is probably the best relationship I've ever been in my life. This is the only, you know what I'm saying, girl I would probably like give another chance. Like, she didn't hurt. Dad wasn't in her life, you know what I'm saying? She had a stepdad, but like, we talked about it. You know, she was willing to be vulnerable and express her feelings in regards to, you know, her birth father. And they had a decent relationship. She was willing to work with him, you know what I'm saying, when he came into her life. But she had a great relationship with her stepdad, you know, and she respected men, how she carried herself. She was like, you know, at first I didn't really want to mess with her because I didn't think she was that attractive, but over time she just, I don't know, it was like I just really saw her inner beauty, And then I was like, wow, she's actually, you know what I'm saying? So I think, yeah, I mean, you got to talk about those things. I mean, sometimes it affects women differently. I've had other girls that I've messed with that didn't have relationships with their father, and that really messed them up. You know what I'm saying? And it, like, I can see how, like, they think and how they were immature because they didn't have a man, like, to show them what a man was. And so now they going off of what they see or what their friends doing and things. But yeah, I mean, not all women, you know what I'm saying, may not have their fathers in their life, are really dealing with the trauma. Some are willing to heal. Some of them are willing to address the issue. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's all you can hope for. Are you willing to work on it? You know?
Yes. And I'm going to read this comment of what, you know, she considers as a grown man, a good man. This man will have integrity, respect, and loyal. I think that's good characteristics to go by.
Yeah.
What about you, Brittany? How do you know when you're in the presence of a good grown man like this? How do you know that?
How do I know I'm in the presence of a good grown man? I don't know if how I know I'm in the presence of a good grown man is how he handles himself, like how he treats the waiter. You know, is he rude to the waitress? Does he have manners? Just like if I'm just in the present, I'm assuming we like on a date. So does he open the door for me? You know, and how does he talk to other people? Because he'll talk to me nice all day. You know, he likes me. So he'll be nice to me all day and pretend to get whatever he want to get. But how did he treat other people, the people around him? Do he talk about his friends when they're not around? When he talking to me, do he speak positive of others? So that's just one characteristic. I'll say, okay, this is a good man. You know, he don't talk about people. You know, that's just for me. That's just one key sign for me, how he treat other people.
Mm-hmm. I like that too. You made me think. I feel like I like a guy that's able to like, stand in what they say in their truth, even if it's not popular or even if they're the only ones that feel that way or think that way. I really like that. It's just like, oh, that's how come I like the outsider people, like the Dame Dashes, the Kwame Browns. Like, I'm always gonna like those people that like may have a different opinion. People may stone them for it, but it's just like, yeah, I find that very admirable, because that's a man to me. You stand in your truth and you ready to fall on your sword if need be. And I'll be right there with you, like, talk your talk.
Now, see, that could be a double-edged sword, though, because what if you meet a man and he, like, you know, as far as I feel like it should be 50-50, and he stand on that. He not changing.
You know what I mean? I appreciate it.
For me, I want a man that compromise.
So do you expect a dude to, like, just go 50-50 off jump, though?
No, I appreciate him standing on that if that's how he feel, but it's just not the man for me. Yeah. Like, but he's still a grown man.
Hold on. Like, real quick, like, so what do y'all expect? 50-50, like, are y'all talking about marriage or y'all just talking about dating?
Marriage. I'm talking about marriage. Because she said she like a man that pretty much stands on, you know, like his opinion can't be moved. Like, he's gonna, if he's like this way, 5 years, he's gonna be the same way. He's on the same thing in 10 years, pretty much.
I feel that way when it comes to like maybe social issues,
or
like
maybe like his morals. His morals,
yeah,
don't change.
Okay, right. Okay. His morals. Yep, that's perfect. Thank you. That's what it was.
His moral stance ain't gonna change. His okay, I get that part.
Change. Yeah, like he said what he said. He said it with right. Chef. I like that. Like, okay. Right. So I'm gonna read this comment real quick. Kanisha said, my father has been in my life my entire life, and I don't want a man like him. However, I used to attract his type. I was married to his type. That's another thing too.
Like, I relate.
Yeah, sometimes people's dad don't be all that, Brandon. So that,
yeah, that's all right. Obviously, you got fucked up father. You don't want to follow in that, or you don't want a man like that. Yeah, that goes without being said.
But see but that's not like people's fault. It's just more so.
Yeah,
like,
I mean, yeah, it's not. I mean, like, where can I? You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, there's a lot of things that, you know, are people in a lot of situations that weren't their fault. You know what I'm saying? You just gotta deal with it, or you gotta look at what, you know what I'm saying? Like, what you want. You know what I'm saying? You have an idea of it. You know what I'm saying? Go to somebody that has something that you think you want. Like, it's not always, because there's people that, my dad didn't have his father in his life, you know what I'm saying? But, like, he had other men, and then he eventually, you know, had my stepfather that came in his life and groomed him into the man that he is. You see what I'm saying? So everybody is born with disadvantages. I mean, that's the beauty of life, because we get to overcome them. So I'm not trying to hear that excuse.
No, I like that, because I admire, like I said, men like Dame Dash. Like, I listen to him and his
like Lil Boosie. Lil Boosie stick to his opinion. He ain't gonna change his mind.
Yeah, but you know,
Boosie ratchet as hell.
Now, he said what he said, though, Sinquilla. Boosie said what he said. Now, he ain't apologized.
Oh, yeah, you were.